About half of the talented filmmakers and writers that I had read the script of The Assurance had a big problem with the fact that I didn't show the big battle at the end of the film between Cordea and the demon god Galhaten. Even one of my highest-ranking crew members said that I stopped the film right when it finally started getting good. And, you know, you might have felt that way too. So I thought I would take this movie here and explain why the film might seem to stop abruptly. It wasn't because of the visual effects challenges or anything like that. That fight sequence was never going to be a part of the equation because it wasn't an important part of this particular story. Now, if the story was about how this world was dying and how Cordea was going to fight to save it, then, you know, yeah, we'd have to show that big fight. But that's not what The Assurance was about. It was about the relationship between these two sisters and how Teyani instilled confidence, literally an assurance, in Cordea that Cordea could do incredible things. The movie starts with Cordea bewildered and fragile. And as we revisit her relationship with Teyani in flashback, we see Cordea put the pieces together and get confident. So once we see Cordea realize her power and be confident enough in her own abilities just to be willing to stand against such a formidable foe, the journey of our story is over. There's just nothing left to tell at that point. As soon as we see Cordea's resolve, we know that Teyani's mentoring worked and the film is essentially done. You know, other stories in this world could, of course, continue to go on, and how Cordea saved the world is a big one, but that's not what this particular film was about at all. The questions that this film raises are along the lines of, you know, why did Teyani leave Cordea in the wilderness, and what was Teyani's mission? But it doesn't have the viewer asking, who will conquer this evil devil god guy, or how will they get rid of this sickness and heal? Those elements were only the framework to bring these two sisters together. In the movie The Matrix, the point of the movie is for Neo to realize that he is the one. Once he does that, there's this little tiny, you know, fight scene with Agent Smith, and it's over. Meanwhile, the entire Matrix evil empire thing is still out there. He didn't save the day or destroy the system. That story was about his journey of self-discovery. Once that happened, the movie's basically done, just like in our film. Now, you might say that a story about saving the world would be infinitely more interesting, and, you know, that's a personal choice. For me, you know, I've seen enough movies with worlds and people blowing up and fighting, and I haven't seen any fantasy films about sisterhood, so that was a more interesting angle to me. Regardless of where you stand on your preferences, hopefully it's a little more clear as to why the final battle scene was omitted in our film.